Hey, what's up, guys? Today we're going to be talking about an insanely powerful comp, definitely one of the highest DPSs overall in the entire game, which is the Ganyu Malth comp. Now, as you guys know, Ganyu came out and is pretty broken. She just does so much damage, it's insane. And I'm going to show you guys my favorite comp on Ganyu and one of the optimal ways of playing her, which is Malth Ganyu. Keep in mind, there are different builds you can run with her. You can run a freeze comp, you can run her with Malth, without Malth, all that. But this is my favorite and it's super powerful, but obviously play her however you want. So yeah, I'm gonna show you guys this insane team, builds, showcase, everything. Hope you guys enjoy. I stream almost every night on Twitch. Follow me if you want. That being said, let's get right into it. The first thing I want to talk about is this team comp, the party composition, and what it is and why it works. So basically, Ganyu is an insane cryo archer who will proc reverse melt all the time, right? She uses her melt on pyro, and it just can deal a ton of damage with every single charge shot and your bloom procs. It's really a lot of damage. So I choose to run her in a melt comp, which revolves around Shangling and another pyro character, usually Bennett. So I run Ganyu, Shangling, and Bennett. Bennett serves as not only a healer, a damage booster, and also someone to give you more pyro particles. So it lets your Shangling get her ultimate more often, and you can just spam your bursts, dealing a ton of damage. It also lets Ganyu constantly proc melt with like every single charge shot, just because of how quickly Shangling's ult can apply pyro. Now, I want to say something pretty important right now before people skip ahead or whatever. I've been talking to a lot of people in various Discords, and it seems like this build is theoretically the best DPS for her because you're constantly melting, you're doing just a ton of damage, and it's what I've been running since day one. Now, the main downside slash weakness of this comp, and you guys should be aware, is that you have to be kind of close, like almost melee range, for it to be effective, because Shangling, who's your main pyro applier, has to be kind of close for a pyro nato to constantly apply pyro, right? Because it swirls around you, and the range isn't super long. Now, this is definitely a weakness, but I think people over-exaggerate this weakness because, yes, it can be annoying in practice and it's better, like, you know, on paper, but when you run it with a character like Zhongli or like Diona, which I usually do when I don't need a character like Venti, and we're going to talk about the flexibility of this comp and how to, you know, what the fourth character should be, but I do tend to run it with a shield character so that I can stay in, like, almost melee range without getting interrupted every time I charge shot, and so that kind of lets me bypass the biggest weakness of this comp, but I still understand that there's valid criticisms toward this comp and why it's not always the best, but it is still very, very strong. But obviously, as I said earlier, play Ganyu however you like. This is how I choose to play her, and the damage, as you guys will see later, is actually crazy. Another benefit of this comp is that the fourth character is actually very flexible. That being said, as my fourth character, I do tend to alternate between a few. Zhongli is my personal favorite because of his shield. Like, Diona works too, but I don't have her very high level, so I use Zhongli with a lot of investment. He'll do a lot of damage and have a very tanky shield, which avoids you, especially when I'm just like vibing on stream. I don't like it when I'm trying to charge shot and just random slimes keep interrupting me. So a shield can be a great option, but also Venti is a character that I use a lot because he's just broken. Like, you guys know this, I don't need to try to sell Venti, but he's so good, especially in Abyss, especially against a lot of enemies. He just is so good with Ganyu's constant AoE, and you can like make the swirl of his ult pyro, so you constantly melt. It's just really strong. There are a ton of good options that aren't 5 stars though, so if you guys are trying to replicate this comp, stuff like Sucrose can work very well. So yeah, throughout this video, you might see me swap the fourth character. You'll see me swap between like Venti, Zhongli, and maybe like Kea or Anemo MC. I'll just be testing a few different parts of this comp basically, but the core stays the same. It's a melt Ganyu comp that just deals a ton of damage and is honestly so broken. So yeah, Ganyu and this comp are both really, really good, and we're going to be talking about how I build every character, a quick guide on all my builds and weapons and stuff, and then we're going to go into the showcase. Basically, for Ganyu, the best bows are both of the 5 stars. Amos is the best and Harp is the second best. If you don't have any 5 stars, there are great 4 star options. In fact, the Prototype Crescent, which is a free-to-play bow, right, it's the blacksmith one, is really good on Ganyu. It's considered to be the best 4 star for her because you just got to do a charge attack on a weak point to get this really nice attack bonus, which does go up with refinement. So definitely what I would recommend as a 4-star bow. Personally, I don't have that bow, so I got a Black Clefable bow. But yeah, I would recommend Prototype Crescent as a 4-star bow. Black Clefable and Verdescent Hunt are also, the two other good 4-star options. And obviously use a 5-star if you have them. I just want to clarify that I got Harp yesterday on stream, so it's not fully leveled and I'm not using it for this video, so I'm just using Black Clefable bow for now. Now let's talk about artifacts. First of all, I want you guys to know that the best set for her, bar none, is just 4-piece Wanderers. If you can get the 4-piece Wanderers with good stats, good substats, on Ganyu. Be sure to use it because it is great. 35% charge attack damage with AD Elemental Mastery is great overall. Now, the problem is this is a very hard set to farm. As I mentioned in my previous videos, you're not guaranteed a 5-star of this piece till AR55, and even then you can get GLaDD or Wanderers, and it costs you 40 resin for like one boss, and it's just really a pain to grind. You guys know this by now, I do not have a good Wanderers set. And so because of that, what I recommend is obviously if you have 4 Wanderers, run 4 Wanderers. Now, if not, there are many good options. I personally like 2 Blizzard Strayer with another 2-piece. That could be GLaDD, that could be Wanderers. Depends on what you have good substats on, because obviously substats are very important. And what's nice about Blizzard Strayer is that since this is a farmable domain, you can keep grinding it, and you can go until you get like good substats. It's actually much easier to grind than Wanderers or Gladiator. And the 15% crowd damage bonus is very nice. Do note that for Melt Ganyu though, Elemental Mastery is actually a priority, so I would prioritize 2-piece Wanderers over 2 GLaDD if you have it, but since they're both very hard to farm, I would say go with like the best substats or whichever one you can use. Now for the specific stats, on Circlet, obviously you want crit, damage or rate, and for Goblet, obviously crowd damage bonus. Now for the Sands, you can either go Elemental Mastery or Attack. Now it depends on your stats, but it seems like getting at least 200 Elemental Mastery or something along those lines is ideal for Melt Ganyu, so you can have a main stat Elemental Mastery on your Sands, but do note that Attack works too, and I'd say whichever one has, like, if one of them has really good substats and the other doesn't, that could be what you prioritize. But especially if you don't have Wanderers and you don't get that bonus AD Elemental Mastery, you really do want some, so I would say EM on the Sands, but Attack works too. And as you guys can tell, I don't really have any good Elemental Mastery Sands from the set, so I use an attack percent one, but I do acknowledge that if I had an Elemental Mastery one, I would be using it for this comp. Also, my substats are actually insane. Like, I've never seen a better Sands than this. It's like pretty perfect. This isn't a flex. I don't want you guys to hate me, but yeah, so this is what I run. I have an attack one with very good substats, and I try to make up for the Elemental Mastery elsewhere, being with Elemental Mastery substats on other pieces, and I do want to run a 2-piece Wanderers at least instead of 2-piece GLaDD because of that. And just so you guys know, my talents are 666, it's only 7 because I have a child in the party, and my constellation is 0 because my currency is trash. So now we're going to talk about the support characters of this comp. First of all, Xiang Ling. For Xiang Ling, you want to be stacking energy recharge as much as possible, so for her weapon, something like a Favonius Lance, something like the prototype Star Glitter, or obviously if you have a 5-star with energy recharge, which is the Skyward Spine, that is your best bet. So definitely stack energy recharge on her weapon. I know mine is level 1 because I literally got this yesterday. Like, I pulled twice yesterday and got this. So I will be leveling it, but for the sake of this video, I'm just going to be using Deathmatch. But do keep in mind that energy recharge is what you want. Artifact-wise, as I said, energy recharge should be your main priority for the substats. Crit and attack obviously are nice, but like, energy recharge should be your main focus and what you need on your Sands. And then I just run power damage bonus and crit. Set-wise, I know a lot of different sets are viable for Xiang Ling. Personally, I use 2 Noblesse and 2 Crimson Witch. It's what I enjoy playing on her, because it's what I have the best substats of, and that really, really matters. But there are many ways to build her. Artifact-wise for Bennett, I have a 4 Noblesse, but I actually would argue that 4 Instructor is better in this specific comp. Now, the reason I say that is because giving this 120 Elemental Mastery in a Melt comp, when your Ganyu is going to be proccing Melt constantly, is actually better than the 20% attack of the Noblesse, especially because it is hit pretty hard by diminishing returns because of how much ult your Bennett will give you, especially with a high base attack sword. But I think overall, yes, you might get less healing because it's 4-star gear as opposed to 5-star, but I think it's just better to have this 120 Elemental Mastery from Instructor versus the 20% attack from Noblesse. So currently I do have 4-piece Noblesse, but running the numbers, 4 Instructor in this specific comp should be better. And weapon-wise, I just run whatever has high base attack and energy recharge. So something like Festering Desire or, you know, any energy recharge sword is good. But obviously, the more stars, the higher base attack generally. So you don't really want to be using a 3-star. But since I have a 5-star with high base attack and energy recharge, it is what I tend to use. So my last character varies throughout the video. So I'm not really going to give you guys a guide on every character you can use, because I feel like that would be kind of redundant. I made a support guide for every character in my last video. You guys can watch that if you want, but basically I usually alternate between Venti, who's running a 4 Viridescent, just like a burst support build, Xiangli, who's a burst support who also likes the shield, and I also sometimes use Sucrose, who's just an Elemental Mastery bot. But definitely like a pretty flexible team. I use Ganyu and Xiang Ling especially, and then the other characters are just complementing them. All right, so now, guys, what we're going to do is a DPS showcase, but the way I'm going to do this is it's going to be the core of the comp, so Ganyu, Shangling, Bennett, and the last character will change. We're going to be testing her in random, just ley lines, domains, kind of like I did in my previous video, but we're also going to be including a floor 11 Abyss and floor 12 Abyss clear, just the half that Ganyu's in. Obviously, my other half will have other characters, but for the Ganyu half, I'll be showing that stuff. For floor 11, floor 12, 11 gives a cryo buff, 12 doesn't. So keep that in mind. Hope you guys enjoyed the showcase. Sub if you're new. Let's go.
I just need
So yeah, there are many ways to play Ganyu. Melt Ganyu is the way that I've been enjoying the most right now, and it has the highest DPS ceiling, but also a high skill cap, and it can be hard to make work. Like even if, especially if you don't have a shield, you can take a lot of damage, get interrupted, and missing shots happen. It definitely happens, so it can be very annoying. But overall, this DPS is insane. I really enjoy playing it, and I hope you guys enjoyed the showcase, the build, and test it out for yourself. So that's about it for me, guys. I'm actually gonna go stream right now. Come watch me if you want, link in the description. So I hope this video was helpful. Subscribe if you want to. If you don't, that's okay too, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.